Around this time, it was actually leading up to the release of that record. It was about 2009 even. I was having this really weird health situation. I was so sick. I could not figure out what was wrong with me. I went from doctor to doctor. I could not get a diagnosis. It was really so frustrating. I have never been so depressed. And out of sheer desperation, I walked into one of these herbal spots, and I lived in Chinatown, New York City at the time. And I phrase it that way because my mother was very into holistics and herbs, and she's, you know, rubbing aloe on everything, and as a typical child of any parent, I sort of just rebelled and was like very into prescriptions. Like, I know there's a pill for that, Mom. Like, you don't need that. And that didn't really serve me that well, I will say. Sometimes, yes. But so at this point, I walked into this herbal shop, and I was just like, give me a leaf, give me a shrub, I will just do whatever. And it was a wonderful Chinese couple. They didn't speak a lick of English. And this man was so special. And he held my wrist, and he would look into my mouth. And I went to him once a week for a year. And his wife was in charge of the apothecary, so it was all the clear jars behind her, cash only. They looked like leaves and sticks and maybe insects. I don't know. She put them in a paper bag, take them home, and I would boil these down every morning, and it would taste so terrible.
Yeah.
And it smelled so bad, but it healed me. I had something called PCOS. I finally got diagnosed.
Me too.
And it was the most incredible journey. And so this song came out of that situation. And basically, my point is this. I think your body always tells you when something's wrong. And it's easy to sometimes not listen. But it's never served me well when I have not listened to my body. And so this is called Hear the Bells.
Love you.
Keeping quiet secrets onto undrained mirror folklore.
stars are watching me. Current takes me out.